Hello friends, welcome to another lecture on this lecture series of computer algorithm. And the next topic that we are going to discuss about is knapsack problem using greedy method. This particular knapsack problem can be solved by many other algorithm design techniques. So today we'll discuss about how to solve it by using the greedy method. In my subsequent lectures, I will also discuss this knapsack problem by using dynamic programming as well as backtracking method. Before moving ahead, I would like to request you all that at the description channel of this particular lecture, this particular video, my quiz link is given. So after watching this particular video, you can attempt the quiz, as well as I have provided the link of all my lectures below. As well as our, it is present in the description section, or you can follow this particular link. For any of your doubts, you can also mail me on this particular email address. So dear friends, let us move ahead and let us try to understand what is knapsack problem and how to solve this particular knapsack problem by using greedy method. So first, let us try to understand what is knapsack problem. So a knapsack is a bag. A knapsack is a bag which has some capacity, storage capacity. In this case, in the diagram, it shows that the capacity of the bag is 15 kg. That means that only 15 kg can be, you can put the objects put into this bag in such a way that the weight of the object is not greater than 15 kg. So anything which is less than or equal to 15 kg is allowed to be placed into this particular. Now, let us try to understand what is the problem. So we are given n objects. Okay. Associated with each object, we have weight of that particular object and we have profit of that particular object. So for each object, let us say in this diagram, there are three objects. Okay. One is PI, object I. This is object 1 and object 2, let us say. So the profit associated with object I is PI and the weight associated with the object is WI. That means that this particular object is having a particular weight, some weight. Okay, and if I put this particular object into the bag, at the time this bag gets filled by this particular weight and I am going to get a profit. I am going to earn a profit of PI. If I put the second bag into the bag along with the first bag, then W1 plus WI will be filled. Okay. And if it happens that W1 plus WI, if it is greater than 15, in that case, this inclusion cannot be done. So in that case, it may happen that for the second object, it may be required to select the fractional part of it. Okay. So the only the thing is that whatever the objects that I want to put into the bag, the total summation of all that objects, WI should be less than 15, less than or equal to 15. Until that only I can place the objects. And whatever the objects that I will place into the bag, the profit associated with that will be earned. I am going to earn the profit associated with all the objects that have been placed into the bag. If I am placing the complete object, object number 1, let us say, so in that case, I am going to earn the complete profit. By some mean, if I am not able to place the object number 2 into the bag completely, but I am able to place the fraction of it, for example, half of the object number 2, in that case, I am going to earn half profit. Half profit, that is P2 by W2. So object I has a weight WI and the knapsack has a capacity M. Okay, along with that, if I consider each item, then the profit PI is there. If a fraction XI is between 0 to 1, of object is placed into the knapsack, then the profit of PI into XI is earned. So there are three things. One is a object I is completely placed into the bag. Okay, and in that case, complete PI will be earned. If some fraction of object J is placed, for example, half of J is placed into the bag, at that time half profit of that one I am going to earn. The objective, what is the objective? The objective is to obtain a filling of the knapsack that maximizes the total profit. What we want to do is we want to earn the maximum profit. Since the knapsack capacity is given, and this is known, that is M, we require the total weight of all chosen objects should be at the most m. These are the some of the constraints. Mathematically, if you want to demonstrate this particular problem, mathematically this particular problem can be demonstrated as, I want to maximize this particular objective function. My objective function is pi into xi, where xi, previously I have told, where xi is between 0 and 1. That is, if xi is 0, the item is, that particular object or that particular item is not selected. If xi is equal to 1, in that case the item is selected completely, and the complete profit of that item will be earned. And if xi is in between 0 and 1, for example, if let us say xi is 1 by 2, in that case we are going to earn the half of the profit of that particular xi. So xi is equal to 1 by 2 in that case. So what is the constraint? The constraint is the summation of the objects that are selected in the bag, that should be less than or equal to m. We want to maximize this objective function, this is a constraint, and these are some other limitations. So one is xi is between 0 and 1 only, and I is between 1 to m. The profits and weights are positive numbers. These are the prerequisites. Then a feasible solution is any set x1, comma x2, so on up to xn satisfying 2 and 3. So what is 2 and 3? This is equation number 2 and this is equation number 3. An optimal solution is feasible solution for which 1 is maximized. So I am sorry, this is 1, this is 2 and this is 3. So 2 and 3 are to be satisfied and 1 is to be maximized. Okay, so this is the mathematical formulation of the given problem. Let us move ahead and let us try to understand this problem by considering an example. So over here, if you'll see, what you will find is there are three items given. So consider the following instance of the knapsack. N is equal to 3, m is equal to 20, p1, p2, p3. So it is p1, p2, p3 is equal to 25, 24 and 15. That is, profit of first item is 25, profit of second item is 24 and profit of third item is 15. Whereas weights of these three items are 18, 15 and 10. So now, these are some of the feasible solutions. There are infinite number of feasible solutions possible. Some of them is half of the first item is considered, half of the second item is considered and half of the third item is considered. When I consider half of the first item, so the associated weight is 9 kgs because weight of the first item is 18 kgs, so half of that. One third of second item is considered here. I am sorry that I told that it is half, but one third of second item is considered. So if I consider one third of second item, in that case the weight will also be associated. Associated weight will also be one third, so 15 by 3 is 5, and one fourth of third item is considered. That is, 10 is the fourth item and one fourth of that is considered. It means that remaining the part considered is 2.5. So total weight wi into xi, if you'll find here, 9 plus 5, 14 plus 2, 16, 16.5, that is here. Whereas the profit will also be earned in that ratio only. That is, half of the first one is 25 by 2. So 25 by 2 is 12.5. One third of the second one, so 24 into 1 by 3 comes to be 8. And one fourth of the third one, that is 15 into 1 by 4. So this comes to be somewhere 3.75. So total, if you see, if you add this all, total 20, 12 plus 8 is 20, 23 and 24.25. So that is here, 24.25, that is here. So this is it shows that any fraction of the objects can be selected. And once that particular fraction is selected, that the profit in that fraction multiplied by that fraction or weight multiplied by that fraction will be considered to be filled inside. Now here, even though bag is not filled, the capacity of the bag given over here is 20, m is equal to 20. Over here you can see the bag is not filled, but I am getting the profit of 24.25. I have another option, that I will x1 is equal to 1. What does it say is x1 is equal to 1, that is the first object is completely selected. If I select the first item completely, at that time I am going to earn this particular profit. So it becomes, profit is 25 plus 2/15th part of the second item is selected. So that means that profit will also be earned in that the ratio only. So 24 into 2 by 15. So if we'll calculate this, what we'll get is, we'll get 28.2, you can check. Whereas here, weight of the first item is 18 and weight of the second item is 15, and 15 into 2, 15th part is selected. 2 by 15 part is selected, 15 get cancels, 18 plus 2 is 20. So even though the bag is full here, I am earning the profit of 28 over here. Somewhere 28.2. Okay. I have another option. So select the third one completely and select the fraction of some fraction of the second one. Okay, so in that case, 2/3 of the second one. So for 2/3 of the second one, so 2/3 into the weight of second one is 15, plus third one is completely selected and that comes to be 10. If you'll see here, so 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15, 5 into 2 10, 10 plus 10 is 20. Whereas the profit that I am going to earn is again in that way, 2/3 of the second item, so 2/3 into 224 plus the third one is completely selected. So 2/3, so it comes to be 8 to the 16 plus 15, it comes to be 31. The profit that I am earning here is 31. And the fourth one, and this is the optimum solution. This is the optimum solution. Based on my experience, I am saying that it is an optimum solution, but this is not the way to find out the optimum solution. Whatever the algorithm that will apply, that should find out this answer. That is xi, the selections xi should be 0 1 1 by 2. Our algorithm should be devised in such a way that this gives this output and this as a profit. So second item is completely selected. Second item is completely selected means the weight of the second item is 15, and 1/2 1/2 of the third item is selected, so 10. Half of 10 is 5, so it comes to be again weight is 20, whereas the profit is second item is completely selected means I am going to earn 24, because the profit of second one is 24, and 1/2 of 15 will be selected, so 1/2 of 15 is 7.5, so this comes to be 31.5. this is the highest profit that we can earn. You can find out, we can try out other many other options, you will find that this is the best one. So whatever the algorithm that we are going to devise, that should generate this particular answer. So in my previous lecture, we have discussed that what is greedy method. In greedy method we devise the solution in stages. We get the solution in terms of stages. So that is, what are the steps, what should be the selection criteria, and based on that selection criteria, our set of instruction should generate the optimum solution. In this case, it should generate the total maximum profit is equal to 31.5. So in case of the sum of all weights is less than m, so it may happen that let us say I have given three items, weight w1 w2 w3 wi is equal to 10 5 4, so total weight comes to be 19, but if m is given as 20, let us say. So if it happens that the total weight is 19, which is less than the capacity, in that case all xi will be equal to 1, means all the items will be selected and whatever is the profit that will be earned. So all optimal solutions will fill the knapsack exactly. All optimal solutions in all other cases, so they will fill it by up to m. So these are the two restrictions that we must know. So what should be the selection criteria? So as we have seen, there is a bag, and it may happen that filling this bag completely, what should be the selection criteria we can consider. So we will go one by one. Let us try to consider the objects in terms of maximum profit. So select the objects first into the bag which is giving you the maximum profit. Okay, so knapsack problem. So this is a subset paradigm, as I have told in the previous lecture also, that since in the knapsack problem, so selecting a subset of the objects is necessary. So we are selecting a set xi, so xi is equal to in between 0 and 1. It can be some fraction, 1/2 also, whatever it could be. So this, in the previous diagram, you can see this one is a subset paradigm. This is one solution. Okay, so this set I want to find out. Then second one is, another thing is that in addition to selecting the subset, the knapsack problem also involves selection of xi, selection of xi for each object. And in this case, we want to maximize some objective function. And objective function is already told to in the previous this one. So now let us try to consider the object, the strategy. Okay, selection strategy. What should be the selection strategy? So let us do it by considering the maximum property. So consider the same example, and in this case, P is equal to 25 is the highest profit. That is P1. P1 is the highest profit. We will consider the first item. That is, we will consider X1 is equal to 1. So X is first item is already considered. When I consider the first item, at that time capacity of the bag, which was initially 20, now it is being filled by 18 kgs. It is being filled by 18 kgs. So remaining capacity now is 2. For the next any of the item, the remaining capacity will be 2 now. So I can now put only 2 kgs into it. For the second object, so second next highest is 24. Next highest profit is 24. But the weight of the second item is 15. So I cannot put 15 into this particular area where the capacity is 2. So I can put 2/15th part of 15. I can put 2/15th part of 15, and which comes to be 2/15. X2 is equal to 2/15. And once I put 2/15th part of his remaining capacity is 0. So this is my subset. My subset is X is equal to 1, X1 is equal to 1, and X2 is equal to 0. X2 is equal to 2/15, X3 is equal to 0. Now let us go and check. So first item is completely selected, second item is 2/15th part of second item is selected. The profit that we can earn is here is 28.2. That means that the selection criteria in which we are selecting the objects with maximum profit in first is not going to give us the correct answer, optimum solution, because optimum solution is this and the selection criteria is giving us this particular solution. So this is not the correct way. This is not the correct way of selection. So we have to select, we have to try out other selection criteria. So one is selection criteria. So one is done. One is done. What is the first one? First one is select as per maximum profit. And as per maximum profit is not giving us the optimum solution that we have seen. That means my selection criteria cannot be selection as per the maximum profit. So if a bag is given to us, in that case what we can think is, we can think to put maximum number of objects into it. Putting maximum number of object into it is putting the lighter objects more. So putting first, initially put the objects which are having least weight, so that if we'll put the least weight items, we will be able to put maximum number of items, and in that case we may earn the profit, maximum profit. So that is the second selection criteria. So from the preceding example, we note that considering the objects in order of non-increasing profit does not yield the optimum solution. So let us try to greedy with capacity and use it as slowly as possible. As slowly as possible means non-decreasing weight of non-decreasing in order of non-decreasing weights. So if we'll do that, so in this case we'll see, let us say, so first minimum weight is this one. So what I will do is x3 is equal to 1 I will consider. If I consider x3 is equal to 1, total profit earned will be p3 initially, that is 15. And initially m is 20, and now since I have considered x3, in that case this 20 is now updated to 10, because this bag with 20 capacity is already filled by a object with capacity 10. So remaining capacity now is 10. So next highest weight is 15 and remaining capacity is 10. So in this case what I can do is I can put 15 by, so remaining capacity is 10, so 2/3, so 15 is the weight, so 10/15th part, 15 is 2/3. It is 2/3. So x2 is equal to 2/3, and profit earned will be now 15 plus 2/3 of 24, because it is 2/3 of 24 is 16, and that comes to be 31. And now m will be updated and remaining capacity is now 0. No other value can be accommodated into the solution. That means that I can earn maximum profit of 31, and this is that particular solution you can see here. So 0, 2/13, 15, bag is filled, and I am able to earn the maximum profit which is again not the optimum solution, which is not the optimum solution. So that is, this selection criteria also does not give us the proper result. So another attempt we can do, in which we can select the items which are having the maximum profit and minimum weight. Maximum profit and minimum weight. So for that purpose, what we can do is we can find out the P by W ratio of each items, and we'll select the items which are having the highest P by W ratio. So maximum is the profit and minimum is the weight. Okay, so in that way also we can do, and let us try to do that. So P I by W ratio we'll calculate over here, and we'll try to identify. So again the same example, and now here I am considering the ratio, that is 1.38 is a PI by WI for the first item. For the second item it is 1.6, and for the third item it is 1.5. First I will consider the one which is having the highest PI by WI ratio. So that is 1.6 is here. That is X2 I will consider is equal to 1 initially. If I consider X2 is equal to 1, profit earned will be equal to profit of second item, and profit of second item is 24. Capacity of the bag initially was 20, but now it is filled by 15 kgs because weight of second item is 15 kgs. Remaining capacity will be 5 now. Second highest PI by W ratio is to be identified, that is 1.5. And over here, if I see the weight is 10. Weight is 10 and remaining capacity is 5. So what I can do is 10 into 5 by 10. 10 into 5 by 10. So 10 cancels. So 5 is remaining. So that is 5 by 10th of that can be considered. So X2 is equal to 5 by 10. 5 by 10 comes to be 1 by 2, as we know. So profit of that will be now 24 plus 1 by 2 into profit of the next item, and that is 15. That is 15. 15, 1 by 2 into 15. So that comes to be 7.5 plus 24, 31.5. 31.5 is the maximum profit that I can earn by applying this particular methodology. So I can go back and I can show you. This is the 31.5. That is, by applying this particular method, we are able to find out the optimal solution. That is, what is the optimal solution? Optimal solution is to arrange the items according to PI by WI ratio and then select the items. So fractional knapsack, that is array W is the weights, array V is the profits, and M is the capacity of the bag. For I is equal to 1 to size, that is if there are N items, then calculate cost is equal to VI by WI. VI is the profit here. Okay, first we calculated the PI by WI ratio. Then we sort in the descending order of the cost, this cost, PI by WI ratio. And then I is equal to 1. From 1, what we'll do is, while size is N, 1 to N we are going to do. So if WI is less than M, M is equal to M minus WI, that is update the weight. And total is equal to, that is profit is equal to profit plus PI. And finally, when you find that WI is became greater than M at the time, the fractional part of that one can be considered. And we'll continue this one up to the end, until the bag is full. So this is all about the knapsack problem. What will be the capacity? What will be the complexity of this particular algorithm? Complexity of the algorithm depends on this sorting algorithm. Whatever the sorting algorithm that we are using, if you are using a bubble sort as a sorting algorithm, at the time the capacity of the complexity is n square. If you are using it as a merge sort or quick sort, it is n log n. So generally the most famous algorithms are, many of the famous sorting algorithms are having the complexity of n square. We'll consider it as n square only. So friends, with this I am done for this particular video lecture. And finally, I'll once again request you to go to the form quiz that I've put into the description channel of this one. Attempt the quiz. Along with that, I have also shared my website page, wherein all the video lectures, link of all the video lectures is available, and directly from there you can select the appropriate video lecture. In my next video, we'll discuss about another greedy method problem. that is job sequencing with deadline. So with this, we stop in this particular lecture. Thank you.